Hello everyone, I'm going to show you how you can bypass a PIN or a password if you have a custom recovery installed. You can see that my phone right now is having a password. So things that you should have is a custom recovery and a PC or a smartphone if you have a OTG cable. You require PC to download some files and transfer them to your phone, or if you have a OTG cable, you can use a smartphone to download those files and transfer them to your phone. So guys, coming back to your phone, you have to power off your device. After your device is shut it down, you have to boot into the recovery mode, for which you have to hold some special combination of keys. For my device, it is volume down and power key. But if you have a Samsung phone, it might be power plus volume up plus home key, and you can open this link for more devices. By the way, if you have a custom recovery, you might already know how to boot into that. So now let me go to the recovery on my phone using volume keys and selecting it using the power key. And here I am on the most widely used TWRP recovery. You might be on any other recovery, but the procedure is the same, and you can see that all the options on all the recoveries are almost same. Now the first thing that you have to do is to go to the mount option and checkmark all the options that can be checked. Now just go back and connect your phone to the PC to transfer some files. You can use a OTG cable if you have. Here I am on my PC, and you have to download this file. The link is also in the description. Now open your connected device and transfer the files that you have downloaded. You have to download this file. And here is the file. Just copy that file and paste it on your device internal storage. Just paste it on the main folder. Now just disconnect your device and you are good to go. I will suggest you to take a backup in case you might do something wrong with the procedure. You can restore the ROM. So just click on backup and select system, data and boot. I'm not going to take the backup of data, but if you want, you always can. Now backup is done, and just go back and back. Now click on install, select the Aroma file manager and swipe to confirm the flash. Now the first time you will flash it, you will see use alternative touches option. Click on the volume down button to move the cursor to yes and hit the power key to select that option. Now you have to select the dots in the corner and keep on pressing that until the next dot is appeared. And keep on pressing the other dot and so on. There will be overall of 3 dots. Now if it's done, you can try if the touch is working properly and click the power key to continue. Here we are on the Aroma file manager. You just have to select the data folder. Now you can scroll down using the touch, but I will prefer you to use the volume keys for going down. Find the system folder and click on that to open it. Now find all the files starting with these prefixes. For newer phones, the prefixes are gatekeeper and lock settings or lock screen. For older phones, the files are gesture.key and password.key. You can see 2 files starting with gatekeeper. And just go down and there are 3 files starting with lock settings. So just select all the files. So just select all the files by clicking on them. Make sure you don't select any other files, and you can see that all the 5 files are selected. Now just hit the menu button. Clicking on it might be a tough job, but after clicking on it, you have to click on delete. And then just select yes, and you are good to go. Now again hit the menu button and click on exit and then click on yes. Now just swipe this bar to unlock the device and go back, and then again go back, click on reboot and then click on system. My phone is booted up and you can see when I swipe up there is no password at all. And you can see that all my files are secured and safe. So I hope that you will like my video guys and please subscribe to my channel, that will be really very appreciable if you want to see more videos like this.